Hello, my friends, and welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited today because I'm going to be giving you a tour of my Notion Knowledge Hub. I have been using Notion as a knowledge hub for probably 6-9 months now, and I have been loving it. It's been a great way to organize podcasts I've been vibing with, articles that I've been really enjoying and want to reference back to, maybe even just articles that I want to read, as well as to store and kind of organize myself as I work through various online courses. It's been a phenomenal tool and I've been loving it, and I cannot wait to give you a sneak peek into it. Let's go ahead and dive in. So I have my Knowledge Hub favorited, so I can always see it from the main menu, but this is a little bit of a tour of what it looks like. And as we kind of go through this, I'm going to tell you some of the things that are working and that I really, really love, and some of the things that I'm kind of still working on with this Knowledge Hub. One of the things that I kind of wish I'd done first is take an inventory of the different types of content I consume so that I could have been a little bit more intentional with this. I kind of created it more with these are all the possible pieces of content I could end up creating or that I could end up consuming. And there are definitely some redundancies and some things that I don't use. So that's definitely something that I would have done different. But in the Knowledge Hub, the thing I have on the main page is, first and foremost, I have kind of what's active at the top. Now, the books I've read this year, this is one thing that I'm still working on, kind of sussing out and making sure it's seamless. Combining my Knowledge Hub with my goals. I usually have a reading target every year for how many books I want to read. I'm super off this year, but I've still read almost 20 books this year. It'll probably be more than 20 by the end of the year. But this is definitely something I'm still working on. Right now, what this is pulling is pulling in something from my key results in my OKR goal setting. So I'm kind of, and I have to manually update this every time I read a new book. So I'm trying to find a better way to automate that, to kind of eliminate that redundancy. And then I have all of the kind of active things. So I have the books that I'm actively reading, which I will admit is a teeny bit out of date. I have the things that I'm actively listening to, and I tend to just listen to a podcast and then be done with it. So there's nothing in here. I have the active courses that I'm taking. So this kind of helps me organize the course content, my notes for the course, the things that I'm actively watching, which again, I don't really track a lot of like the watching and the listening stuff. And then I have this to review page, which these are things that maybe are pieces of like books that I want to make sure I read, articles that I want to make sure I pull in. So this is tends to be pretty long, but I tend to use it to kind of help me figure out what content might be good content for me to consume next. So that's kind of the top part of this. And then down here is really the core of the Knowledge Hub. So I have my little menu over here. I have this library inbox, which how this library inbox works is it is bringing in pieces of content from the library database, which we'll take a look at in just a second. Oops, I didn't want to go there. But it's filtering it by things that were last edited in this current week. So anything that I kind of edited recently, as well as, oops, I clicked out of the filter guy, the things that have a rating that is empty and a status that is to do. So basically, this is meant to be a way where I can capture the things that I've recently been checking out. Maybe it's a recent article that I saved so that I can easily get back to it. So that's another place that I can use to go in and find some of the stuff that I recently captured. Then other than that, really there's one main database that runs this entire Knowledge Hub. I have a library database, and this library database, as it sounds, is the library of all of the different pieces of content or different pieces of knowledge that I have consumed or plan to consume or have saved. And actually, I am currently reading The Ruthless Elimination of Hurry, so we're going to add active to that. And you can see a lot of it are books. Some of these are old books that were pulled in when I had my Notion set up connected to Readwise. Now, Readwise is a great app. And for those of you that aren't familiar with how Readwise works, it connects to your Kindle account and it basically can import any of the notes or highlights or anything like that that you took inside of a book into your Notion system. So like this is a great example of that. I read the book Burnout by Christina Maslach, and these were some of the notes that I took and some of the things that I highlighted. I ultimately disconnected that application and stopped using it because I really found that I would have these things imported in here and then I would never use them. I actually find that the things that I've used more have been like, for example, when I have gone in and I have, you know, physically added in my own notes and takeaways. So like, for example, I have these screenshots. I have some things that I highlighted and I took from the book. Sorry, my Notion is
being mean right now and not letting me scroll. But these are things that I found to be more helpful to me, is to manually input my takeaways as opposed to having the random highlights. So I disconnected my account from Readwise. I don't use Readwise anymore. But you can see I have it sorted in a lot of different ways. I have 2023 sorted, and basically it's sorted by the date completed. I also have an automatically updating summary that uses Notion AI. I don't use this summary a ton. In fact, it is not even wrapped. We're going to resize this guy. That's how much I use the summary. But then you can see I've sorted by the books I read in 2022, 2021. And you can see this is a low book reading year for me. I'm at 16 in here. This one has 35. This one has 29. I think I read a ton in 2020. Okay, that has 37. I think my highest reading year was probably 2018 and 2019. So I read 51 books that year. And I read 57 books that year. So I keep track of that. And I also keep track of my favorite books so I can kind of go back to them. And then I've also got it separated by articles, podcasts, videos, as well as the books I've read by date. So there's a whole bunch of different sorting options in here. But one thing I want to say about this library is I was asked by a client who I was helping build their system if they recommended, or if I recommended, them having separate databases for each of their different types of content. And I actually would say no to that. And the reason for that is, especially when I'm saving articles, for example, I tend to use the Save to Notion feature. And basically I have this automation already set up that will automatically pull whatever it is that I'm saving into my content library. And the benefits of only having one database, only having your library database instead of like a podcast or a book or a video database, is you don't have to set up multiple different Save to Notion automations to do that. It's super easy and you just can have the one to pull in stuff from the internet. Same thing on my phone, just being able to go to the library and add something to the library instead of having to go deeper and be like, okay, where's the podcast directory, the podcast database? When I'm working on my phone, it just makes it a lot easier. So I do recommend, if you're planning on doing something like this, just have one library, one database that is all of the different pieces of content, and then you can sort them accordingly, which is what I did down here. So I have these different content types. I created kind of a sub database that is different content types. And basically all these are pages where my library is sorted. So if I click into books, I can see all of the books that I've read. And I have it displaying the status as well as the date of completion. I have it sorted so I can see all of the different articles. I have it sorted so I can see the different online courses, which I only recently started using it for online courses. So there's not a ton in here for online courses, videos and movies, which again, I mostly use this if I'm saving like a YouTube video that I want to refer back to, and then audio/podcasts. So again, each of these are just pulling from the library database and they are filtered to show only one particular type of content. That's really the gist of how it's set up. Now, one final thing I have in here is a learning progress page. This is an idea that I got from another YouTuber. And I really only use the learning progress to keep track of how far I am through different courses that I'm working on. And actually, I'm way further through this. I'm actually on module 4 right now in this one. I don't really use it to keep track of books. I find it kind of irritating, frankly, to keep track of books. So this is a page that if I were to do this again, I probably wouldn't use in the future because I have other ways to keep track of my progress through courses. Like you can see that each of these courses is actually connected to a project in my Notion system. And I keep track of the progress mostly through this progress toolbar, which measures the amount of checked actions that I have. So this is probably something that if I were to do this again, I wouldn't do again, because I just don't use it. But if you have another, don't have another way that you are tracking the progress you're making through these different things, that might be a way in which you could do it. And this is a super easy thing to set up. You just have a target, which usually is how long the thing is, whether it's a course or a book, how much of it you've completed. So whether it's the number of modules you've completed or the number of pages you've read. And then the progress toolbar, I just have it set up to round and it's just a fraction. I did completed divided by target times 100. And this times 100 divided by 100 just rounds it properly so that it isn't giving me like a weird decimal. And then I just went in and I set the property to be, okay, let's move my face. I set the property up to be a percentage and to display it as a ring. So that's really all that is, if that's something that you wanted to set up. But that is the gist of my Knowledge Hub. It's really just this one page. And again, I find it super helpful for keeping track of book notes, keeping track of podcasts that I've been listening to and that I took something from. So like you can kind of see, let me actually go into a podcast example because this might be a little foreign. So like I had, was listening to this podcast and they were talking about some things like the structure of self. And he had some like affiliate codes that maybe I'll eventually go to. So I just took a couple of notes in there. Same thing with this one. I took a ton of notes during this particular one. So like as I'm listening to a podcast, maybe I'm out on a walk, I'll just pull my phone up and jot down a note. So I even actually, you can see in that one, I even tagged myself as a reminder to go in and look at something. So that's a little glimpse into my Knowledge Hub, how I use it, some of the things that I would have done differently if I were to set this up again. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions, any thoughts or ideas that you want to run by me about how you might set yours up. But I hope this gives you a little sneak peek into the how, the why, and some of the functionality of having a Knowledge Hub.
There you go. That is it. That is the, oh God. Okay, we're keeping that in because I overtrained yesterday. Was it yesterday? Yeah. And so my legs are like absurdly sore and I feel like I'm learning to walk. It's that bad. If you've ever done that, poor, drop a comment below because it's been rough today. Getting around my friggin' studio apartment has been hard. But anyways, I hope you got some nuggets, some things out of that tour. If you want to build your own Knowledge Hub, go ahead and drop a comment below. What are the things that you are excited about being able to kind of track and keep tabs on? What notes are you excited to be able to go back to? You know, did you know about the Save to Notion feature? I'm actually probably going to be doing a video on that in the future and all of the different ways I use the Save to Notion Chrome extension. So if that is something you are interested in, drop all the comments below. I'm super excited for some of the upcoming content on this channel and I am super excited to share it with you. So once again, as always, thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for watching. If you've been loving what you've been seeing, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will talk to you next time. Bye, friend.